Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this brown box. This is part of the Ubiquiti Unify Access range, and this is the intercom viewer. I'm going to show you what's in the box. In this video, we're going to be slightly different, not just show you just what's in the box, but just show you a couple of things of how this works as well, as I think it probably will answer a few questions that people have. So let's go through what you get in the box. You are going to get your conformity guide, which you probably won't open. You are going to get a couple of screws. You are going to get some more screws and lugs to mount the back plate to the wall, and you're going to get a quick release tool. Remember, the viewer here is designed to go inside your sales office or inside an apartment or on different floors of your building. It's not an outside secure. It's designed for the user on the inside. So we're not trying to secure this on the outside of a property. You are going to get a drilling guide there with a level on it. There we go. All right. You are going to get a backing plate. Put this up the right way even. Here's your multi-backing plate. All right, you will need to have a cutout on the wall. We'll have a look at the device a little bit more at the moment, but it is PoE powered. All right, so you're going to need to get an Ethernet cable to it. You're going to mount that plate to the wall. You can then bring the device up, hang it into place like this, if I've got it all up the right way. And when you lock it into position at the bottom, you'll actually see it will link into that hole there. That's what we use this quick release tool to push into if we want to release it from that mounting afterwards. So back plate, then you're going to get the device itself. So let me show you. Obviously this is a two-way communication device. There we go, without glare on it. All right, so we've got our microphones and speakers and our LCD screen so we can actually see what's going on. Not a lot happening on that side. We do have some LEDs over on this side. All right, and as you can see, we've got our standard reset and our PoE in. Like I said, this is a PoE powered device, but this does not need to be plugged into the UA hub. This can be plugged into any device that provides PoE as long as it's on the same network segment, i.e. the same IP range, as the device, the OS console that is running Unify Access. All right, so let's talk a little bit about how this all operates together and show you there some stuff on the screen when it starts up as well. So this, like I said, will run on its own. There is new firmware. We're recording this in April 2024. It's only just come out. There will be some new firmware, I believe, in due course that will allow you to connect this to the G4 doorbell and use it as a two-way intercom, which would be fantastic as well. You can mount those, you know, up one upstairs or one in the kitchen or somewhere, so you don't have to necessarily use your phone to be alerted all of the time. So I am just going to quickly find a Ethernet cable and plug this in and power this up. All right, that's great. And then let me just show you. So if you're not seeing it already, this is designed initially to work with the intercom. All right, the intercom or the whole UA access, the Unify Access system, each door needs to have one of these. It needs to have a UA hub. Without the UA hub, the whole thing doesn't work. All right, so you do want to bear that in mind if you're thinking this looks quite an exciting option for you. You do need a UA hub, which is PoE plus, I think it is, powered. Again, one for each door, and then you connect your door strikes for automatic door opening. Without that, it doesn't work. Right, so our viewer has powered up, as you can see there. Let's just get that about right. There we go. I've already named this main house, and I'll actually give you a little bit of demonstration of how I change that in a moment. So all being well, I'm going to hold this over this side here, all right, and I'm going to grab our intercom from this side as well. So the intercom, done some other videos on that. You walk up to the door, you can use your NFC off the back of your phone or a pin code to get in, or you can hit this doorbell button down at the bottom. All right, when I hit the doorbell button down at the bottom, oh, I've just asked it to put a pin code in. Let me just get my hand in the right place. When we hit the doorbell button at the bottom, all right, it will list up a directory. There is talk that maybe this might remove in due course. So this is why I wanted to show a few of these bits. I'm going to show you in a minute how I've renamed this. So I've renamed this main house, idea that this was just for a house. But basically that's the name of this viewer. You could have had that as apartment one or apartment two. So I can then click the button again All right, and as you can see, it has actually started, and there you go, there's a look back at my studio. All right, and then I could have obviously talked back to that person on here. So let me just try and see if I answer that. Hello, now we've got reverb video, so cut some of that off. All right, I can see the person at the end of it here. All right, and I could have then used the option to unlock the door, and the door is unlocked, and then I can stop the call. All right, so if I wanted to, the other option is I could actually see who's at the door. I've got that button there called Live View. All right, and I can actually use it, put that on mute so we don't have too much echoing back. There you can see. I'm actually using that as a viewer to see if there was anybody at the doorbell as well. So there's my intercom working with my viewer. Few people have asked, can a viewer be linked with multiple intercoms? Yes, it can. I don't know whether it'll be able to be linked with multiple doorbells. I assume maybe it would be able to, but definitely you can link it with multiple intercoms, so that therefore you can all have multiple doors accessible via one of these. So somebody goes to the back door and you've got one, or somebody goes to a different apartment and pushes the button, you would still get a call on this. So obviously this is our viewer. It's going to see what's happening and going on, puts itself to sleep when it's not operating. Now on the screen, I will just grab a little bit of a screen record on here for you of what I'm about to do, just to give you an idea of the actual steps I went through, just to get rid of a couple of issues that I'd spotted on here. So you do need the Unify Access app if you want to get alerted on your phone. All right, and as you can see, these are my main components that I need to make this work. I've got a main gate, which is what I've called it, which is actually my UA hub. That's the core, the guts of it all. And then I've got up there the main gate, which happens to be the main gate intercom, which is this setup over here, which we've done another video on if you want to see a little bit more. And then the main house, that's my viewer. All right, I could have named that viewer whatever I wanted to. So if I went in and changed that to call that a let me just see, I can make sure I can spell and talk at the same time, apartment one, and save that. All right, and let me save it. If I was actually to come up to the intercom now, all right, and push the doorbell here, you can see it says apartment one at the top. All right, so there's a lot of options that you can do on that. Now on a door, the way I worked around this was slightly is you can have what is called an attendant. If I was actually to look at the intercom and to go to settings, I think it was, no it wasn't, let me go back into here and work out, oh, sorry, it's on the actual door here. We can have attendants. All right, a door attendant is the person that gets alerted when the button gets pushed. If I was to actually add one of these, and these are really your Ubiquiti users, you'll actually notice on my screen here that I now have administrator as the view. That would mean I would get alerted when the intercom was pushed or called for that, which is okay, but I don't really want my name to appear on there. So if I remove myself here from the actual door itself, but you'll actually see what I've done is I've gone to the viewer, and the viewer has the same options to add door attendants. And I've actually got the door attendant that you can see there as info. So with that door button is pushed twice, and let's do that, you can actually see on my phone that I'm actually being alerted. So not only is the viewer now powered up and ready to go, but I'm also being actually alerted there on my phone as well. All right, some people had asked about how that was actually done. Was it taking over the whole screen or anything? You can see there from the screen record, unfortunately not. It is only taking over just a small part of the alerting portion. If you have notifications differently, maybe it could alert more on your phone as well. All right, so hopefully that's given most of the bits that people have asked for on this. They want to know, could you have a viewer across multiple doors? Yes, you can. Can you change its name? Yes, you can. Can you have multiple viewers for the same door? Yes, you can. All right, so that's again, you could put those up, one upstairs, one in the kitchen, or if you're in an apartment, an office block or something, maybe there's one at reception, but one also in the sales office or something like that as well. So it's really, really, really versatile as a solution. Obviously the size of this compared iPhone 12, there you go, gives you an idea. the screen. Obviously, it's got the sounder in there, two-way conversation. And if you link that with UA Access, with the hub that we've got there and a door strike and everything, then you can unlock the door from it as well. So I do hope that's been useful, answered a few questions, at least just shown you what it looks like as well. Plenty more videos over on our YouTube channel, box openings on wireless network and firewall devices and camera security as well. What do I need to run Unify Protect and Unify Network? Soon there'll be one up there on what do I need to run Unify Access as well. So why don't you head over there, subscribe, and stay up to date.